This is the YGTV News.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Tuesday, the 12th of February. I'm Giordano Durante. RGP seizes CTS equipment. Locals charged for cannabis possession. Gibraltar to host first face and body painting festival. Gail Francis Tiron launches successful second exhibition. And finally, YGTV Pancake Day photograph competition. The GRA have today announced that steps have been taken to shut down CTS, who now no longer provide authorised electronic communication services. A search warrant was executed by the RGP in support of the GRA, and all CTS radio communications equipment was seized. The GRA notes that any remaining CTS customers can, if they wish, approach other existing providers of these services who have been asked by the authority to facilitate the provision of such services to existing CTS customers. Stephanie Brabin, aged 39, of Raven House, Road to the Lines, yesterday pleaded guilty in the magistrate's court to the possession of 65 grams of cannabis resin. She received a £600 fine. A guilty plea to possession of 25 grams of herbal cannabis received no separate penalty. In the same case, Jose Marquez Hurtado, aged 39, also of Raven House, pleaded guilty to the possession of 25 grams of herbal cannabis and a further 65 grams of cannabis resin. He was also charged with two counts of possession with intent to supply the drug. His case was adjourned for sentencing until the 4th of March 2013. This April, Gibraltar will see the launch of its first annual face and body paint festival. The event will run from the 12th of April to the 15th and will see a mass of competitions, workshops, trade stands, face exams, and nail art exhibitions. Organiser Hamish Dalmedo claims that one of the main reasons he wanted to introduce this type of festival to Gibraltar was to advance on this fast-growing new form of art and give locals a chance to work with some of the world's best artists. He noted that it posed as a great opportunity for locals to volunteer as models or even try face or body painting for themselves. Yesterday evening, former Miss Gibraltar, Gail Francis Tiron, held an extremely successful launch for her second solo exhibition, Day 11, Part 2, which featured works by local artist David Formiga Corsi, Gail's son, Casey Asopardi Francis, and budding young artist, 8-year-old Emma Dalmedo. The exhibition incorporated a number of themes from the recent period of time that saw the end of the Mayan calendar and new beginnings. The pieces reflect a regeneration of the appreciation of everything natural, as well as some apocalyptic scenes. Gail's exhibition was attended by Culture Minister Stephen Nannis and local artist Christian Hook, as well as the Reenactment Society. And finally, following the success of YGTV's daily photograph competition, we are hosting a further photo contest for the best and most original Pancake Day photograph. The winner will receive a voucher for a meal for two at Kitchen on College Lane. Photos can be sent to info@yourgibraltartv.com. A winner will be announced on Thursday. Participants are urged to be as creative as possible. That's the YGTV News. We're back tomorrow evening. See you then.